in the ring, weighing 252 pounds, the Genius!
Not exactly a warm reception here for the Genius.
At this time, we are about to hear a poem from the Genius.
I'd like to say we are honored, Alfred, but I don't think that is the word to use.
See the beauty of the Genius and the world's smartest man. See the glory in the bosom of the average wrestling fan.
Bosom?
Beefcake's barber shop will soon be strutting down the aisle. But he never will eradicate my iridescent smile.
I tell you, Alfred, with the flowing locks, the Genius is a little bit much to take.
You've heard
the expression light in the loafers. I think the Genius is a little light in the wrestling boots.
Well, I don't know about that, but it's positively weird, that fellow. There's something weird about him.
Well, Brutus the Barber Beefcake plans to cut him down to size of this encounter. Saw him back in the locker room area sharpening up his shears.
Yes.
And I think he knows he's got a lot to work with in this encounter. The Genius sporting some rather thick locks atop his head underneath that cap. And what a reception Brutus the Barber Beefcake has received here in La Crosse, Wisconsin.
That certainly is an unusual pair of leotards that he's wearing there into the ring. But then, of course, he's never been anything else except the Brutus Beefcake that we've come to know.
No, Alfred, he's not only a barber, he is a stylist.
Yes, and there are those shears. As you say, shiny and sharp.
Shiny and sharp. We're about to get this one underway. The Genius taking time out here to do a little posing. You must subscribe to Muscle Magazine.
Well, he has got a very, very nice build, the Genius, but then again, it's not quite as nice as that of Brutus Beefcake, who is a powerful, powerful wrestler and probably doesn't have to pose anyway.
Well, he wants to wrestle. He's ready to get this one underway.
Oh, no, I think he is going to pose.
And it seems the crowd here in La Crosse likes his poses much better. The Genius is a little green with envy, Alfred. Oh, a little insult there to his posing.
Beefcake is trying to provoke the Genius as much as he can, and now he's mocking him and sort of doing a parody of what the Genius himself does in the corner. I really don't think that enhances Beefcake's chances of winning this match. I think he ought to concentrate on going for his man instead of prancing around like that.
Well, Brutus seems to be accomplishing what he set out to do.
Mind you, the crowd loved it even, so they thought it was very, very funny. And I suppose to be great it was, but I'd rather see some wrestling.
Well, we are seeing some right now. The Genius in a very vulnerable position. Brutus the Barber Beefcake can do just about whatever he wants at this point.
Yes, both men are very capable wrestlers. Both have a lot of class, a lot of style, some tremendous moves, and I'm sure we're going to see that put into action.
Well, Brutus elects to use the headbutt to the midsection.
That was a nice move.
Well, you can see from there it was effective as well.
That is a lot of hair that the Genius has there. You're absolutely right about that, Sean. And it's grown awfully quickly.
I would think that he could have a nice little business on the side promoting hair growth if he has certainly found the secret.
Yes, that was a nice entrance into the ring.
Well, those gymnastic moves may look pretty, but they're not going to help him in a victory over Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
No, I think Brutus is ready now to really take his man apart. He's mocked him, scoffed him, and played and toyed with him a little bit. Now he's ready to knock him out.
Ray Morella trying to get a break here. Brutus gives him like a half break and then gives him no break at all.
Yes. Brutus, a very, very successful wrestler indeed. Always rated very, very highly in the World Wrestling Federation rankings. And the Genius, of course, has had his share of great victories. some surprising ones. Very, very surprising indeed. So this should be a very closely contested match.
Wait a minute. What? Oh, but I've never seen anyone's hair move like that before.
Just look at that. That's one of the funniest things I've ever seen.
You messed up his hair.
Oh, gosh.
Now, wait a minute.
No, I don't think that's... Well, I'm sure that's not his hair.
I think the genius has been revealed here.
Yes.
And Brutus the Barber Beefcake plans to reveal even more. And now it's the genius who comes back with the attack. And what has added to his incentive here is the humiliation that he has just suffered in front of this capacity crowd in La Crosse. Drop kick.
Well, I don't think that the genius was so stupid after all. That was a brilliant ploy, in fact, by the genius. He trapped Brutus Beefcake completely there.
Oh, the
hair's off of it. That is... Why is the wig
there? That is obvious there. It is a wig. And although that hair has grown back some, Alfred, from a previous encounter with Brutus the Barber Beefcake, you can still see that there is a lot missing.
Well, he better concentrate on his opponent, Brutus Beefcake, because playing with the hair is not going to enhance his cause at all. It's not going to help him.
It's too late now. Everyone has seen it. The wig gone. He might as well just lose it completely. And he does. Brutus the Barber Beefcake securely plants the sleeper. And the genius once again in serious trouble with Brutus the Barber Beefcake. As Brutus brings him back into the center of the ring, he is a long way from finding any sanctuary on the ropes. And the crowd is going wild. I think they are anticipating what indeed might take place, Alfred. Let's get the official word. It's obvious.
Here is your winner, Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
And the genius, as you mentioned, Alfred, should have spent less time worrying about his hair and concentrated more on trying to mount some offense against Brutus the Barber Beefcake, who is known to be one of the toughest competitors in the World Wrestling Federation.
He certainly should.
He's putting the wig back on the genius. And I think that the genius's sideline, I mentioned before, is just to put out of business. He's not going to be receiving any more letters about how to grow massive hair. Brutus the Barber Beefcake looks as though he is going to do a little trimming. I guess he didn't like the wig. And is improvising with the genius's wig.
Yes, he's
enjoying himself a great deal out there. And I think if the genius were conscious, I don't think he would be enjoying this at all. Just adding more to the humiliation of the genius. Self-proclaimed intellectual. Got another look at what took place earlier on. And what a flip here by the genius as he lands right on top of Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
It certainly was. And at that point, it looked as if maybe the genius was going to beat Brutus, but he messed about with that wig, and that was his downfall there. A very impressive victory by Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Alfred, right now, let's return to the primetime studios. Earl Monsoon and Bobby Heenan.